How's it going, everyone? My name is King Big Dip. Today, we're gonna play a little bit of Transport Fever 2. Excited to play this game. I am really big into the logistics type games, so let's get started with a little bit of the campaign here.
Mankind is constantly creating amazing new inventions. Get involved in rapid technological progress and ensure smoothly running transportation in different regions of the world.
Excellent. So campaign number one here. Let's go ahead and select that.
America, in the midst of the 19th century. In the Nevada territory, where until recently only a handful of buffalo grazed, nowadays it's all hustle and bustle. Beyond the Sierra and near the Carson River, gold has been found. There's supposed to be loads of it. All you need to do is dig it up. Anyone who keeps at it hard enough will be richly rewarded. What a splendid opportunity.
What a splendid opportunity indeed. We all know how the gold rush ended up, though. At the end of the gold rush, many people that went to California in search of gold ended up penniless. But the people who made the real money are the transport tycoons who transported all of that gold for them and cashed that money in when it got to its location. Other people who made a lot of money, the people who had services available in California, your grocers, your tool salesmen, those people made all of the profit from the gold rush. It was not the people in seeking the gold. Remember, every opportunity is not necessarily the opportunity itself, but how you can service those in seeking that opportunity. Let's start here with this mining miracle. In the Nevada territory, so it's gonna be a little desert biome here. It's gonna be chapter one, mission number one. So it's probably gonna start early on. It was in the 1800s. I'm probably gonna be pulling a lot of stuff by horse or maybe by trolley, but we'll see. We'll see what we get into the game here.
Welcome to uncharted territory, newcomer.
Thank you.
Wanna get rich?
Absolutely.
Then you're in just the right place.
Excellent.
Gold rush fever holds sway in Virginia City. And you lucky devil, you've won the mining rights for a promising claim in a poker game at the Red Dog Saloon. Soon, you'll be hauling out gold nuggets as big as a cat's head.
Oh, yeah. Don't know why it's so specific as a cat's head, but here we are nonetheless. All right, to the mission, Mining Miracle, searching for the shaft. Thanks to the cleverness and luck at the cards, you have a gold mine all your own. Former owner, a gal at the saloon by the name of Susie who plays a lousy hand of poker, already took care of the groundwork. And, a practical woman, she left the necessary equipment behind, too. Now all you have to do is find the mine.
Get an overview and find out where the riches lie.
Whoa. Tilt the camera.
Discover the entrance to the tunnel.
There it is.
What a promising claim. Even though only a few boulders have been mined so far, that's no reason to lose heart. You'll just have to dig deeper. You ought to get hold of some solid timber from the nearby forest so that the fine shaft doesn't cave in. The beams will be excellent for stabilizing the tunnel.
This is interesting.
Build a station where the horse carts can be packed with logs.
All right. I'm assuming it wants me to build it in this little blue square here.
Explain to the sort of thick-skulled driver which route he should take.
Thick-skulled, I gotta do it for him, huh? So I gotta go from here to here.
Now, there's got to be a small depot to park the horse-drawn carts, too.
Is that right? Well, let's name that line while we're here as well. I'm gonna call it Virginia City Lumber. Easy peasy. And then he says we need a depot, put it in the square area, I would imagine. Let's kind of like line it up with the street to make it kind of a nice little spot there.
Everything's all set. Now, all you have to do is to get hold of a cart to transport the wood.
Okay, I imagine I go into the depot here, buy vehicles, and here we are. So we have the horse-drawn carriage. It is a passenger carriage. It supports four people. And then we have the American horse-drawn carriage that supports cargo of timber. So we're going to buy one.
A sturdy vehicle. The transport can get started.
All right, so now we're going to select this vehicle, and I think we're going to select the set line button, and then Virginia City Lumber.
It won't be long before it's possible to dig deeper.
Boom.
Well then, good luck.
All right, we're going to hit play, and out comes our little carriage. There he goes. Tip, in addition to the pause mode, there are three game speeds to choose from. Real time, double, and quadruple speed. Okay, so let's hurry him up. Whoa, there he goes! And there's more wood waiting as well. The pile gets bigger as more is collected. Oh, we start out with a nice spare $10 million. Small loan in 1865. Starting out with quite the advantage here. In the California Gold Rush. Got a bunch of industrial buildings along Virginia City. So he should be bringing four logs over to this station. He's gonna drop it off at this terminal. And boom.
Ha! Not everything that glitters is gold. Maybe your poker partner was sharper than you thought. Despite all the hardship, the mine only brings in a few chunks of silver ore. At best, you ought to get rid of it before it ruins you. Luckily, new greenhorns constantly get stranded in Virginia City, who you can peddle that confounded pit to for good money. So, you got rid of the silver mine for a decent amount. Time to invest this money in a lucrative venture.
A decent amount?
It's an excellent opportunity.
I got rid of it for $100 million?
Transported to the silver mines down by the river. A railroad that takes over the transport would be a promising venture.
All right, well, I guess we'll take over the railroad, but $100 million, sure. That's definitely what this silver mine was worth. So I think they want us to go in here and select the buildings. And what did they say? Cargo station? Yeah, let's do a cargo station. But let's do a terminus station. And let's shorten it up. Right there. Oh, select the variant, which is 120 meters long. Oh, I can pop it right onto that. That's excellent.
The terrain is treacherous. Requires a few very twisted curves.
Connect the open ends of the track. Oh, this is neat. Okay, so what we can do is come in here and go to the tracks, the standard tracks. I think we're gonna build a tunnel through here. Yep. Excellent. And then we're gonna come around this bend. Nice. And then I think we're gonna cross this chasm here with another bridge. That's a beautiful little bridge. Love that. Stone arches that go all the way down to the base of that valley. All right.
Build a railroad route that rapidly transports all the ore to the valley.
All right. So we're gonna create a new line. We're gonna take it from Virginia City to Carson City.
A respectable railroad calls for a proper railroad yard.
And we're gonna name that to, what will we name it? Virginia to Carson Silver. Excellent. Okay, and then they want us to build a train depot and place it right over here.
A truly and well connected. Done structure. Now it just needs to be connected.
Let's make sure we leave plenty of space for it to move quickly. Excellent.
It's high time to buy a beautiful locomotive together with a few freight cars.
All right. Buy a beautiful locomotive, a Baldwin six-wheel. The top speed of 25 miles per hour, a whole 95 horsepower. This thing can haul, I don't know, 10 logs? Or a little bit of silver, if you prefer that. Let's go ahead and add that to our list here. $258,000 added. And I believe we want a gondola that can haul that silver, or, I don't know, a few. Only has 95 horsepower, so we really don't want to tack on too much. Let's go ahead and buy it for $1 million. Oh. Not enough vehicles available.
What
there you go.
A handsome iron horse. Time to send it on its maiden journey.
All right, and then we need to select that Virginia to Carson Silver Line.
Our transport is picking up speed. With a little luck, it'll make you richer than all the silver in Nevada ever could.
All right, here she comes. Love this music. Let's hop on board. Woo! We're going a whole 20 miles per hour. About to be 25. That's the top speed right there. 25 whole miles per hour. Heading through the Nevada countryside. Or Nevada desert, depending on how you want to look at it. Woo! This is quite the pretty route. Oh, got a little autosave there. So beautiful. Yeah, I gotta say, this game is very, very pretty so far. Very happy with it. And we're arriving at Carson City. The drop off, $48,000 worth.
Smelting is moving fast and furious. Meanwhile, all sorts of fine ladies and high-class gents get off in Carson City. Make sure they don't ruin their good shoes on the muddy streets. Find out about the needs of your future passengers.
All right. Activate the land use layer.
Your services are needed to the same degree everywhere in town.
All right, we want to build a bus stop. Wait, did they also want me to have a passenger station here? I feel like I will end up building one. Industrial area, a commercial area, and a residential area. All right, so we want one here. We want one here. And we want one here.
Make sure your coaches don't miss any stops.
All right, this is going to be Carson City. Internal. All right, and it's going to go from here to here to here.
Build a depot where the horses can be hitched
Excellent.
Up and the coaches can wait.
All right. Building a depot? That's a depot. All right, so we're going to take a depot and build it somewhere nice. I'm thinking maybe at the end of this street or along this street. Right there. Perfect.
Just a few coaches with horses so that you can get started.
All right. I think it wants me to buy three of these. So one, two, three. We're gonna... three horse-drawn carriages and set them on the Carson City Internal.
Great. The first passengers are already waiting.
All right. So that's a great way to tell
what is needed. The Territorial Enterprise reports. A beast is up to no good in the area. Yes, the deed is done. The first train is rolling down the line. People are dropping everything to cheer your marvel of engineering. Let's have a big round of applause. Hooray! There's no end to the rejoicing. It's all thanks to you.
Okay. I think I should also create a passenger platform on this. Maybe there? What would it be able to service if we put a passenger? Interesting.
Where not too long ago there was nothing more than a dreary two-bit town, a magnificent little city now flourishes, thanks to your transportation services. The locals even call it the Miracle of Carson City. More and more people want to try their luck there. Obstacles shouldn't be put in their way. Get into the passenger business. Your tickets will be the hottest item in town.
All right.
Make sure that the rest of the world is finally connected to Carson City, a veritable boom town.
Okay, I think it wants me to focus on this right now, so I guess that's what I'll do. So I'll build a passenger station over here. Excellent. And then I'll build some tracks. And I want to go along the terrain. I think that's what's super important here, to not spend way too much money. Kind of make that track as straight as possible. Excellent. Just doing a little bit of curving to get to our location. And make sure we're not having to deform the land too much. Inspecting along the tracks. Excellent. And now we just want to come along here and get pretty darn close and ready to connect these two pieces.
By
excellent.
A train arrangement that brings people from all over the world to Carson City.
All right, build a new depot. What we'll do is we'll build it out here, and the tracks will go both directions. Make it nice and wide, so speeds are not reduced at all, or as little as possible. It can go either direction now. All right, we want to buy a locomotive with three passenger cars. Boom.
Time to inaugurate the line from Reno to Carson City.
All right.
Built on silver.
And we want to name this new line Carson.
There's firewood up in Glenbrook that'll get the steam engines and the silver works puffing real nice. But watch out that you don't cross paths with the Cartwrights from the...
It'd be Carson City to Reno. Passenger. And then we'll go back over here and we'll set the line to Carson to Reno.
We're off and running. Everyone is dead set on riding your beautiful railroad.
All right. Now, can we replace this with one of these. Excellent. Now it's a multi-purpose train. Now we should be able to haul both people. As well as cargo. On the Carson City to Virginia City line. Alright, let's see what these tasks are.
The reporter, a certain Mr. Clemens, has revealed his source to you. An old good-for-nothing by the name of Sam Hawkins. He's supposed to be in the saloon in Virginia City. Could be it means buying him a couple of shots of hard liquor before he comes up with the truth.
Uh-huh. All right.
The man was happy to provide information. The monster got a few feet taller with each whiskey you bought him. Word has it that it gobbles up whole cows. Picks the remains out of its teeth with a wagon tongue.
Oh, is that right?
Farmer thinks it's hanging around near the Ponderosa Ranch, if he's not mistaken.
All right, the Ponderosa Ranch, up here.
Old Cartwright and his son didn't take too kindly to your visit to the Ponderosa Ranch. Apparently, you're not the first to be hot on the monster's heels. The rancher claims that dozens laid siege to their land, but just when he was about to run them off, they hurried away towards Lake Tahoe with a paper hot off the presses in their hands.
All right, heading to Lake Tahoe.
The Territorial Enterprise reports. The wild man is dead. His body was committed to the waters of Lake Tahoe, where it will sink to a depth of over 600 feet, be encased motionless in a block of ice, and shrink to the size of a small child due to the high pressure. Well, guess not much can be done about that.
That's funny. All right, let's see what this one is. Ponderosa Ranch. All right.
You barely got away from the Cartwright boys. Now get a respectable load of logs down to the valley as fast as possible before the ranchers come back again.
All right, so now we want to deliver some logs. So we want to get some, maybe a truck station built up here. Want a footpath connected to there just to make that delivery of logs even faster. And then we want our garage or road depot. We want to buy some horse-drawn carriages, maybe three. Okay, and we want to make a new line from up here on the logs, Ponderosa Ranch, down to this truck station where they have a little log warehouse. We're gonna name this Carson City Logs. Excellent. Now we're gonna go back to the road depot and set these up for that route. And off they go. Now let's see, how's this going? No passengers just yet, huh? Did I do this wrong? Shucks. Got some logs available there. It seems people don't really have a need to get from Carson City to Virginia City, way over here. At least so far. Quite interesting. We got a few people waiting over at this one, though. This one has a nice little thing for the people. This one does not have that same overhead on the platforms. There you go, a platform roof. Maybe people will be more inclined to take the train if they have a roof over their heads. Oh, maybe if we put an underpass for them as well. Excellent. Maybe a side entrance. That's cute. Love that. All right, we're gonna turn down the music. Looks like we're about to deliver some logs. Excellent.
The silver business is doing splendidly. Cluster of pathetic shacks has become the swankiest town in the whole West.
All right.
Where you find the most exquisite shops, the best saloons, and the loveliest ladies of ill repute far and wide. Many an opportunity suggests itself to spend those silver dollars you so richly deserved. Your railroad business is the real gold mine. The state of Nevada.
Yeah, we love that. We love to see that. All right, that is going to be mission number one complete here in Transport Fever 2. Man, I'm really liking this game so far. Thank you all for coming by and watching Transport Fever 2 with me. This has been episode number one. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I will see you all in the next one.